This is large-scale, labour-intensive agriculture. The industrious workforce of 200 people are earning on average £54 a month, £6 more than the national average. These are skilled agricultural jobs which are much sought after in the region. I've just stepped out of the desert to find myself in an oasis. I asked Mr. Farid El Farhani, the nursery manager, to show me the source of this verdant fertility. So what's up here then?
The basin of irrigation.
Oh my goodness! I feel like I've gone delirious mad with the heat. It looks like a giant swimming pool. So where does the water come from? Where do you get it from?
Water is origin in the ground, 140 meters.
Morocco uses 92% of its water for agriculture at a time when approximately 2 million Moroccans remain without access to a clean water supply. Intensive agriculture has been responsible for polluting water resources due to fertilizers and pesticides seeping into the groundwater. The water quality in the Sousse Valley is now considered to be at critical levels. Agricultural irrigation is lowering the water table, and Morocco is being forced to look towards expensive seawater desalination to supply its drinking water. Once the water's in here, then where does it go from here?
Two filters.
Okay.
Okay.
Then after it's been filtered, where does it go from there?
To pour for irrigation, the plants, the nursery, the plants.
Tomatoes are a thirsty fruit, with 1 kilogram requiring about 20 litres of water. As Britain imports 18 million kilos of Moroccan tomatoes a year, that means we're consuming 360 million litres of this increasingly scarce resource. What I saw at the nursery was truly eye-opening. I've now come 15 kilometres down the road to Agafé de Sousse farm to see where the young tomato plants get planted and picked. Set in over 80 hectares of land, the farm exports 2,100 tonnes of cherry tomatoes to the EU and UK every year. This is tomato production on an industrial scale and a long way from the popular image of the tomato allotment or smallholding. The mild climate in the Sousse Valley, which enables year-round production of tomatoes, also encourages insects, bacteria and viruses. There's a virulent pest called tomato leaf miner, which is spreading rapidly through Europe and Morocco. Parts of the British Isles are so worried about infestation that there's been talk of banning Spanish and Moroccan tomatoes. What are you using to disinfect the soil to get it into state to grow the tomatoes? And are you complying with EU rules to do that?
We work with des insecticides respectable European. Ils peuvent, les Anglais peuvent faire des contrôles. Et s'ils voient un insecticide, c'est nous qui perdons.
Oh my God, this is just incredible. So much fruit, finely seen tomatoes.
Ici, c'est une variété de tomates qui s'appelle Sarah. Uh-huh. On la plante spécialement ici au Maroc pour l'expédier vers les pays Angleterre et Allemagne.
These are so different from the misshapen ones I found in the souk. I can see why they're so popular with the UK supermarkets, because as a variety, they're perfectly round with very little variation in size. Are these popular here in Morocco? Do you sell them to Moroccans?
No, no. Les Marocains ne mangent pas beaucoup ça. Ils mangent la tomate grosse.
I'm about to take the cherry tomatoes on the first leg of their 1,500-mile journey back to the UK. It's 10 a.m. and once picking begins, the clock starts ticking. These cherry tomatoes now have 80 hours to get onto our supermarket shelves in tip-top condition. First stop, the farm depot, where the tomatoes will be graded and packed. This sorting depot processes up to 24,000 kilograms of tomatoes every day, headed for the UK, Germany, Holland, France, Russia and Sweden, and exports to Tesco and Co-op up to four times a week. All the EU nations where these cherry tomatoes are headed have different quality controls, with our British supermarkets requiring that all our tomatoes are one size of 25 to 30 millimetres and a particular grade of redness. It's 4 p.m., 6 hours since the tomatoes were picked. The graded tomatoes are now loaded into a van ready for their 8-hour, 450-mile journey to the ferry port in Tangier, the first leg of their 3-day journey. I've seen everything but the lorry now. Oh my God, how big is this thing? I'm hopping up and down with every little bump in the road. God only knows what the tomatoes in the back are going through. I'm sure they've turned into sauce. As you can see, I'm on a really big gas-guzzling lorry, and my consignment of tomatoes requires refrigeration all the way home. You might think this isn't the greenest way to get your cherry tomatoes, but you'd be wrong. The carbon footprint of tomatoes grown in Spain or Morocco is 3 times lower than those grown out of season in UK heated greenhouses. And that's despite their exhausting 3-day journey over land and sea through Spain and France. Our massive demand for fresh, out-of-season cherry tomatoes is creating an ethical dilemma, while importing these to the UK creates jobs and a valuable income for Moroccans. It's contributing to water pollution and a critical water shortage. So, should we really be buying them? You decide.
Coming up, the cheapest supermarket of the week.
Right, well, juicy.